Coming up on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report, we go behind the scenes with the fab freshmen of men's hoops. We go underground to dig up the greener side of sports. And we're talking baseball with Coach Dave Tillett and softball with Coach Dave Deros in our Coach's Corner. All that and more on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report.
The FGCU Sports Report is made possible by Mutual of Omaha Bank, matching the right financial service to the right customer at the right time. Mutual of Omaha Bank, your bank every step of the way. And employee-owned Home Tech, serving Southwest Florida for 30 years with service agreements on air conditioning and all major appliances. And by the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery, dedicated to your good health always.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health always.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
Hello, Eagles fans. I'm your host, Tom James, and welcome to another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. When you enter a college sports program as a freshman, more often than not, you ride the bench until you learn the system. But men's basketball coach Andy Enfield had some big holes to fill in this year's lineup and was compelled to give some of his first-year players a bit of a baptism by fire. Sports reporter Josh Siegel spoke with three of these fab freshmen and files this report.
Andy Enfield, FGCU's first-year men's basketball coach, lives up to his word. On a recruiting trip before the season, Enfield told Brett Comer, an 18-year-old prospect from Orlando, that he should be prepared to start immediately. Freshman jitters be damned.
He came to my house, he kind of made it clear that, you know, he wanted me to come in right away and be the point guard for this team and the point guard for the future for him, you know. And that's basically what made me come here right there. I want to go somewhere I'm going to play right away. You know, obviously it's going to make me feel good, you know. I mean, that's what sold me. Just like the coach coming in having that much trust in me straight out of high school.
Enfield threw Comer, along with three other freshmen, right into the fire. Comer, guards Bernard Thompson and Dante Holmes, and forward Philip Svetichinen all have started and finished games for an FGCU squad that has already won the most Atlantic Sun games in program history while clinching its first conference tournament berth. Comer has shaken off that initial fear to lead the A-Sun in assists.
At first, you know, you're a little nervous and unsure about what's going to really happen. You know, everybody says it's so much different. You don't really know that until you step onto that first game. It's so much more physical, faster, stronger, and you can't get away as much stuff like you could in high school.
Usually, freshmen learn passively from the bench, but FGCU returned only six players from last year's team, and that large turnover has forced its freshmen into action and to learn on the job.
It's the best way to learn. You're not going to learn unless you're actually in there doing it, you know. And then, you know, with me with a whole bunch of young guys doing that, we're going to learn to get so much better together for the continuing years. It could be ridiculous what we could do.
Thompson, a slashing athletic guard from Georgia, leads all A-Sun freshmen in rebounding and steals while ranking second in scoring. He describes an FGCU culture where young players don't look over their shoulder, but rather make mistakes together and grow together.
It's fun. I don't think it's a lot of schools got freshmen starting like me and Brett, and sometimes Dante. And, you know, we got Phil, who can shoot lights out. He just really lets us play. So, you know, we try to pick each other up. Even though we make mistakes, we just try to play through them.
Comer, Thompson, and Holmes live together and bond off the court. Before the season started, the five-man freshman class sat down and talked about making FGCU men's basketball relevant.
FGCU hasn't really been on the map like this. We're bringing people in, gets the fans coming in. It's exciting games. Game's fun to watch now. We're making history here. Just to be here, just to be at FGCU is just amazing.
Svetichinen, a freshman three-point specialist from Croatia, moved to the U.S. last August, eager for the chance to play basketball. Philip's father, Danko, played on the Yugoslavian silver medal squad at the 1988 Summer Olympics and the Croatian silver medal team at the 1992 Summer Olympics.
A lot of things are different here, like people, how we practice, school, how school and sport is connected, so pretty much everything is different.
In Europe, students at universities cannot play basketball. Instead, they play on outside clubs that function as professional teams.
There is no campus. Like, you can't go to school, come home, and go practice, like, next to your home. I really like it. That opportunity that they gave us, that you can go to school and go to gym and practice every day, and everything is so close. You got people that are taking care of, that are helping you.
Enfield plays as freshman because he knows they can help him win now. Although at first he had his doubts.
We're trying to build a program, but we're trying to win right now. We gave the freshmen a lot of minutes early on, and they continue to play big minutes for us. They've all started games throughout the season. We expect them to keep improving. We've put up with a lot of growing pains as far as coaching staff goes. They turn the ball over, they play poor defense at times, but they do a lot of positive things for our team, and that's why they play so many minutes.
Enfield lets players play through mistakes. As Alico Arena's student section fills up and the outside community embraces this young team with a future, Enfield can't say he didn't see it coming.
It's probably beyond some expectations, but it's not beyond ours. We expect to compete for the league championship this year, even though we're very young.
Thanks, Josh. And don't forget, sports fans, you can always find the latest news, scores, and highlights for all of FGCU sports at FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Softball coach Dave Deros here with us on the Sports Report. Well, you're a couple of weeks into the season, coach. What have you learned about your team so far?
Well, I think we've shown flashes of brilliance. We've shown that we can pitch it well. We've shown that we can catch it and hit it well, and hit it with power. The only thing that we have to do more consistently is just try to string it along together and put them together more often.
You said prior to the beginning of the season that this could be your deepest team ever. Why do you say that?
Oh, it is. It definitely is. We are too deep at every position on the field, which is something that we've never had. If you look at our box scores, we're using 12, 13, 15 players during a game. That's something pretty much unheard of for us. We have some options, and it's nice to be able to go into a game knowing that you can go ahead and play situations.
Now, the interesting thing about that is that you play a lot of players, meaning you have a lot of depth, but you also have a lot of youth with a lot of underclassmen on this team as well.
We've only got two seniors, a starting catcher and one of our starting pitchers. So the great thing about this is that this team is going to be together for the next 2 to 3 years, depending on their age, and they're going to get better as they go along.
You've been here for a decade, and you've always been known as having all these great power-hitting teams. Mm-hmm. But last year, the bats seemed to cool off just a little bit. Why was that?
It's the reason why I'm great. power hitting is usually the last thing that comes. When you typically hear baseball commentators and analysts start talking about teams, and if they're talking about a young team, they basically say that there's going to be a dearth of power in their lineup, and that's basically what our situation is. Our young kids have got to learn how to situationally hit and how to go ahead and look for opportunities to go ahead and drive the ball, and that typically is all of all the hitting and offensive skills the last thing to come. So it's going to come because we have the talent, we have the raw materials. Now we just have to put the experience along with it, and we'll see that good things are going to happen.
Is it the sort of the law of averages that you'll finally have a cooler hitting team come along after having so many great hitting teams?
Well, you know, the cool thing is this is our 10th year playing softball, and we've had our top 10 moments. We published those online. We had our 10 most influential players in our history. And if you take a look, in most cases, they did the most damage in their junior and senior years when they were later on and had more experience. And that's what this team is going to go ahead and figure out is as they get a little bit older, a little bit wiser, they'll be able to control, in my opinion, the most difficult athletic skill, hitting a softball. I think they'll be able to control that situation a little bit better.
When the current young players see all the hardware and see how many wins you guys have compiled over the year, does that make them want to bring this team back to the elite and back to the top?
Absolutely. And, you know, and again, our 4 years away from postseason competition has made a big difference for us. This is a team that came here with the idea that they would eventually be able to go ahead and compete. and be able to do something at Division I postseason level. And if not, I just, you know, I pull out the A-Sun conference watch, bring it out to conference, to practice every now and then, just show it around and say, hey, don't you guys want one of these?
A lot of great competition in the A-Sun this year. What's it going to take to finish at the top or near the top?
Well, I think we're taking the steps right now. We're playing tough competition. We're playing tough teams. We're putting a lot of games back-to-back, and we're trying to give our players as much experience as possible in difficult situations. Everybody that we play is you know, comparable or even better than what we're going to play in the A-Sun. So by the time we get to the end of the season, I think we'll be battle-tested and seasoned.
Do you do that on purpose? I mean, do you try to play as tough an out-of-conference schedule as you can so that you're battle-tested by the time you hit conference play?
No, because we're down here in the state of Florida, a lot of teams want to come down here to open their season. So as a result, the opportunities are rife to be able to bring in those kinds of teams. So it's in our best interest always to be able to go ahead and go against them, regardless of the record. What we want to see is how they're going through the process and how they're evolving as we go along the season.
FGCU finally postseason eligible now. How much of an extra motivation does that give your players, your team, your staff, everybody?
Just from a selfish perspective, this is my 10th year here at FGCU, and in nine of our seasons, six of them I've been postseason ineligible. So it's nice to be able to know what that, you know, that we don't have a definite end to the season. We don't have a definite date that's our cutoff. We have a golden opportunity to go ahead and move forward into the conference tournament. And, of course, if we win there, be able to move on into the into regionals.
Well, one more thing about your schedule. And, you know, you talked about how easy it is to get teams from around the country to want to come to play you guys here at the FGCU Softball Complex. You don't leave the state of Florida until April to play anything on the road.
No. I had the March 15th rule. And I figured this out our first year when we went to East Tennessee State on March 15th. It's cold in other parts of the country. I don't know any better. So we're not going to go above I-4 unless we have to until after March 15th. I figure that's a play the law of averages and make sure that we take care of our players and take care of our coaching staff.
Early in the season, you already have a player of the week in the A-Sun on your roster.
Freshman Kelsey Carpenter had just an absolutely marvelous weekend this weekend at the plate, and we played her in a lot of different positions. She did a great job.
Dave Deros, thanks for joining us. Have a great season.
Tom, always good to see you.
All right. And just a reminder, you can always like the Sports Report on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And watch your favorite episodes of the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health, always.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
A wonderfully manicured playing field is just a thing of beauty for the fans to gaze upon and for the players to play upon. But it takes more than just some grass seed and sprinklers to create a field of dreams. As sports reporters Rod Clark and Ryan Varanish explain, creating this kind of perfection is a dirty job.
With baseball season in full swing, the FGCU turf management crew is hard at work making sure the Eagles are ready to protect the nest on a nightly basis. But if you think all it takes is a little mowing and some water to maintain a field like Swanson Stadium, you may want to think again.
A lot of people think taking care of a field is just cutting grass and dragging dirt, and there is a lot more to it. Like you're seeing me do today, I'm rebuilding the mound, putting it up to the height that our pitchers would like it, and so forth. You have to be a little bit of an electrician. You have to be someone who knows irrigation and drainage. I mean, if I have a sprinkler head that fails, I have to replace it. So there's a lot more to it.
For FGCU turf manager Tommy Vita, a career in turf management grew out of a passion for baseball that was cut short by injury. 39 years later, Tommy brought that passion to Southwest Florida.
I used to play and got hurt, and I couldn't play anymore, but I still wanted to be around. So I started doing field work, and I just grown to love it. This is my 39th year doing this. For part of that, I was a school teacher. I taught PE, I was an athletic director, and I coached football. But then at 39, I went back to school to get a degree in turf management. But once I came down here, I had to learn everything completely different. I'm from outside of Chicago, and the grass and the climate is so much different, you have to learn completely different things to do. I've learned a lot of it on the go, and I think that's the best way to do it.
For the turf management team, it's not just about making sure the field is painted to NCAA standards or that the pitching mound is at regulation height. It's about improving the psychological landscape of the field before the game begins.
Most of baseball or most of sports is psychological. That you, if you think to make the players think that you're doing something for them specifically, they react much better.
After managing the 82-acre spring training home of the Texas Rangers in Port Charlotte for a decade and a half, even a seasoned veteran like Vita admits that a smaller venue presents its own unique challenges.
My biggest problem with all three of my fields are they drain so well, and it's very difficult for me to keep them with the moisture level that I would like to have. The biggest challenge is during the winter when we get the cold snaps. For example, you've got to be able to irrigate at the coldest part of the evening, which is usually between 4 and 6 a.m. So you try to set your sprinklers so that you keep your field moist. It doesn't do a lot of damage. The grass doesn't freeze.
Despite the time he spent with a major league team, Vita says he enjoys his work here at FGCU, and he concedes that the big leagues aren't all they're cracked up to be.
I love this. I don't have near the pressure that I had. I enjoy coming to work every day. You don't have to deal with the egos of the major league players, which can be difficult because each one of them wants it specifically for them. I've been here going on almost 8 years now, and I haven't regretted coming at all. I don't miss the major league guys at all.
If experience has taught Tommy Vita anything, it's that two heads are better than one. So graduate assistant and FGCU alumnus Anthony Galvin helps out with the daunting task of keeping Swanson Stadium in pristine condition.
I do absolutely anything that he needs me to do. I show up and it changes every day, which makes it fun to come to work. I drag the field, I mow some of the fields, I mow around the fields, weed eat, just whatever Tommy needs me to do.
Despite having worked with the team during his tenure as a student at FGCU, Galvin agrees that keeping the field in working order is definitely no picnic.
Working out here, I mean, I played baseball all my life. I worked for a baseball team here, and I didn't know that there was this much that went into this profession. I thought, you know, put some water on the grass, and the grass grew.
Thanks, guys. Great story. And as always, you can find the Sports Report on both Facebook and Twitter. And you can watch your favorite episodes of the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Dave Tillett, baseball coach, joining us here on the Sports Report. And coach, the season, you're 1 week into it. Your team, your youngest ever, half of them are freshmen this year.
Well, we're going to grow. I mean, we got our feet wet this weekend, and we learned a lot about ourselves, and we continue to grow, and I think once we get into conference play, I think we're going to be an okay baseball team.
17 of your 34 players are freshmen. Now, you've got a lot of heavy hitters on your schedule this year out of conference. Florida, Miami, Michigan, Boston College, Florida State, Texas Tech. Wow.
Wow. I don't know what I was thinking when we did it. But, you know, I mean, that's who we are. We want to play the best people in the country, and I think that's why our recruits come here, because of who we play and how tough the schedule is.
Now, replacing the top of your order, that's where you lost some key guys, most notably Zach Maxfield, your all-time hits leader. How's that going to work out with finding new bats to put in those spots?
They're young. I mean, they're young. They're untested. So, I mean, the lineup will probably change weekly. And by the time we get to conference play, I think we can zero in on the lineup. But those are big shoes to fill.
And pitching is one area where you actually have some really good experience.
We do. We, with Ricky Knapp and Jason Forget and Patrick Nathanson. And so we're a little bit stronger on the bump than we are positionally as far as age.
You won three straight A-Sun titles between 08 and 2010. Last year, the injury bug really caught up to you guys. How is everything this year in terms of the health of the guys as we're just getting started now?
Well, you know, we were healthy going into the weekend, but we lost Patrick Nathanson for 8 to 10 weeks, it looks like, which is a big blow for us. He was throwing two in our rotation. But, I mean, that's part of the game. You know, someone has to step up.
We talk about how much youth that you have on the team, but the positive end of that is that you have a lot to look forward to, I guess, in the years to come.
Oh, we're going to be very talented. I think next year might be the best team we've ever put on the field. I mean, once these kids grow up and we get Brooks Beisner back, I mean, it's going to be a pretty good offensive lineup and a pretty good bunch of guys on the mound.
Swanson Stadium, always a great place to come watch a baseball game, and I'm sure for you guys to play. But some more improvements have been made in the offseason for Swanson this year. Tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, Swanson Stadium is beautiful. It's a great home atmosphere for us. Our kids love playing there. We have a stadium roof, which can keep us away from the sun. So, I mean, it's really big for us. We have some banners that hang down from the stadium that really, really look nice of Dwayne and Chris and Casey and our first championship team celebrating. So, I mean, it's a beautiful place. It's a beautiful stadium.
Chris Sale, who you mentioned, former Eagles star, working out with you guys in the offseason before heading off to Arizona to be with the White Sox. He's been told he'll start this year. Do you think this can be a real breakthrough year for Chris out there?
Oh, I do. I mean, he's worked very hard this offseason. I mean, he's been in the weight room with our team at 6 a.m. He's really putting in the time and the effort to make this a very special season for him.
For the players that weren't around to play with him, what kind of a positive influence has he been on your new guys to have him around?
Oh, it's very positive. I mean, he tells them the way it is, and him and Casey both. I mean, when Casey's around, they spend a lot of time with our kids. It's just great environment to have two big leaguers that played for you to come back and continue to work around the kids and be around the program.
You had a lot of new recruits obviously coming in this year, and most of those kids are in-state recruits. Is that something you did by design?
Yes, I mean, because the state of Florida is, I mean, it's loaded with talent, and we get our fair share, but we are starting to get some kids from out of state now, but most of our talent will always come from Florida.
You know, what have you learned from this team in the first week of the season? You took on Bethune-Cookman in your first series at Swanson Stadium, and then you just took on Miami. Have you seen some positivity and things that you should feel good about already?
Oh, I feel good about them. You know, we just made young mistakes. The speed of the game kind of caught up to some of them because you can't simulate that till you really get out there. But it was a learning experience. I think each week this team's going to get a little bit better.
All right. Coach Dave Tillette, baseball coach here at FGCU. Great having you on the show.
Thank you for having me.
All right. And just a reminder, everything that you ever wanted to know about FGCU sports and more is right at your fingertips. Just type in fgcuathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Well, the clock has run down on another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. We'll be back again next month to bring you more behind-the-scenes coverage of FGCU athletics. I'm Tom James. Thanks for watching, and go Eagles.